find your preschool parents. For week two in this box, we have the little red hen as our theme. And I'm gonna go over a few tips on what to expect for the week. So on Monday, we have the oatmeal dough. So in the box, I included a little bit of the oatmeal dough already made and some oatmeal. So again, this is a project that you can build on as big as you like or make as small as you like. You can take out cookie cutters and they can just play with it. You can add the oatmeal with different measuring materials. Like you can use different spoons, you can use cups, you can use small, little, medium or large. Just play with it, anything you like. And I also included the ingredients of the Play-Doh in case you were curious. And if you like to make it, it's very simple. You just combine your dry ingredients and the wet ingredients and put the wet ingredients in a medium pan. And as soon as that starts to get a little warm, you can add your dry ingredients and just keep mixing until it starts to get a little solid, then turn it off and keep mixing, keep kneading it until you get Play-Doh consistency. Super simple. Most of the stuff everyone has in their pantry. I think the cream of tartar is probably the only thing that not everybody would have, but that's easily found at any grocery store. So there's that. And on Wednesday, we have the Little Red Hen handprint. So these are super fun. So with your box, everybody should have gotten a bag. And inside this bag, I have the red paint. So what I like to do with the kids when we're painting our handprints is I'll use a brush to paint on the paint onto their hand. Or if you don't have a brush, just a cotton will work. So you get a little bit of that and then just paint it right onto the hand. And it's very interesting to see. Of 8 years that I've been on the preschool, they just will sit there and you can just tell them, how does that feel? It's also works their five senses as far as feeling the cold of the paint. It's kind of squishy. Some kiddos don't like the texture, and that's okay. So if you just go quickly and then just put their handprint onto the paper and then wipe it off as soon as possible. Usually don't have any too many issues with kids who have sensitivity to paint, as long as they don't have it for too long on their hands. I also included a few feathers so you can decorate the hand once it's done. So that's super fun. And you might want to save a little bit of paint because on Thursday, they're going to be making trees and they're going to use the paint to use their fingertip to make apples. So that's kind of fun. Okay, and on Friday, I have some number loaves here. They're these. And what I did was to trace the numbers, you can use your fingertip and you can do any small objects. Let's see. Right here I have some beads and you can just, they can take their finger and trace the one. Now this works, you can use the oatmeal that I put in, or you can use, I've seen some people use salt. So that's something that's easily accessible. Be creative, you can use anything, and that's also a sensor project and will help them memorize their numbers. So perfect. And again, in the bags, I included a pair of scissors and I also put some beads in here and a little bit of pipe cleaner. So in case you're looking for something a little extra to do, you can also make patterns. So they can do an AB pattern, do pink, white, pink, white, or they can make a bracelet. You can do whatever, be creative. There's some more Play-Doh in for the very busy spider. So one thing you can do with this is save it for that Play-Doh. You can stick it onto the Play-Doh and then they can continue to make patterns that way. So that's kind of a fun little project to do as well. So, all right, my friends, those are my tips for week two. Enjoy. Hope you guys are having fun with your boxes. See you soon. Goodbye.